السلام عليكم ورحمة السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to tonight's class, tonight's مدرسة الممتعة class, صرف class 41 إن شاء الله. So today's topic, continue from yesterday's topic where we treated Jadwal Sorfi, which is the Sorfu table. So inshallah, today we are moving on to Jadwal Sorfi lil afaali fi awzani ruba'iyya, which is the four lettered verbs. So yesterday we treated the three lettered verbs, and today inshallah we are treating the four lettered verbs. And as we explained yesterday, the Sorfu table has seven columns. So the Sorfu table has seven columns, and we can remember that we are using the book Tasriful Mubtadi by Sheikh Adam Al-Ilori. So, but because we noticed that some of these texts have some errors, so I decided to recreate this table here in a clearer format and an error-free format, inshallah. So inshallah, the seven columns that we have in the Sorfu table, we have what? The fa'ilul madi, the fa'ilul mudari, masdar, ismul fa'il, ismul maf'ul, fa'ilul amri, and fa'ilul nahi. So those are the seven columns. So the first verb that we will be treating under the af'alu ruba'iyya is af'ala. So we have af'ala, and when it goes to mudari, it becomes yuf'ilu. Then masdar is what? If'alan. The ismul fa'il is muf'ilun. The ismul maf'ul is muf'alun. And the fi'lul amri is af'il, which is a command. And the fa'ilun nahi, which is a negation, is la tuf'il. That's a prohibition. So those are that is for the af'ala waznu. And an example here is what? Arsala, which means he sent. Arsala, he sent. Yursilu, he is sending. Irsalan is what? A message, or the act of sending, the word to send. Mursilun, a person that sends. Mursalun, a person that is sent. That is where why you hear Allah will refer to the messengers in the Quran sometimes as al-mursalun, those that are sent with a message. Arsil, it is what? An imperative verb saying what? Send, a command. La tursil, that is a negation that says what? Do not send. So we notice that in that textbook we see that there is an error here, that it said la taf'il instead of la tuf'il. So it is not la taf'al, rather it is what? La tuf'al. Remember that your fa'ilun nahi and your fa'ilul amri are coming from your mudari. So since this is yuf'ilu, then the fa'ilun nahi is just la tuf'al. Another common example we have under af'ala shape is what? Aslama, which means he submitted. Aslama, he submitted. Aslama yuslimu, he submits, or he is submitting. Islaman, the act of submission. So that is how you say what? Islam is what? Submission. Muslimun, a person that submits. Ismul fa'il. Muslamu, ismul maf'ul, something that is submitted. Fi'lul amri is what? Aslim, it is a command. Submit or accept Islam. Then fi'lun nahi is what? La tuslim, do not submit. So we go on to the next waznu, which is what? Fa'ala, which is the second ruba'i verb. Fa'ala in fi'l mudar it becomes yufa'ilu. Then in masdar it can have two shapes, although the textbook mentioned only one shape, but we know that it can have what? Two different shapes, which can be what? Mufa'alatun or fi'alan. So either with mufa'alatan or fi'alan. Then ismul fa'il is what? Mufa'ilun. The ismul maf'ul is what? Mufa'ilun. And the fi'lul amri is what? Fa'il. And fi'lul nahi, la tu fa'il. So an example there is what? Kataba. That is what? Write. When we have fa'ila, it means two people are doing something together. So Kataba writes with something, write with somebody or make somebody to write. You katibu. Kataba, he was writing with another person. You katibu. He is writing. Tabatan, the act of writing, or kitaban, then the ismul fa'il is what? Mukatibun, a person that writes. Mukatabun, a person that is being written with. Katib, a person katib is what? Is imperative, saying write. La to katib is the prohibition, that do not write. Then we have what? Jahada, which means he strove or he fought jihad. So we can it can be he strove or what? He fought jihad, he made jihad. Jahada, you jahidu, he is making jihad or he makes jihad. So you jahidu mujahadatan, although that is a less common used form of masdar from jahada, but the more common one is what? Jihadan. So that's why we say that fa'ila can have two masdars. Then we have what? Mujahidun, a person that makes jihad. Mujahadun, that is the ismul maf'ul. Jahid is a command, that make jihad or strive. La tu jahid, do not strive. Then the next shape that we have under the ruba'i is what? Fa'ala. So fa'ala in fi'l mudar it becomes yufa'ilu. Mazdar it becomes tafa'ilan. Then the ismul fa'il is what? Mufa'il. While the ismul maf'ul is mufa'al. The fi'ilul amri is what? Fa'il. And the fi'ilul nahi is what? La tufa'il. So an example there that we have is what? Allama, which means he taught. He taught somebody else. Fa'ala, he taught. The past tense of what? Teach. While yufa'ilu, yu'allimu, he is teaching. Then the masdar is what? Ta'liman, the act of what? The act of teaching. That's why you hear some people when they're going to madrasa say they are we have ta'lim. So what? The act of teaching is what? Ta'liman. While what? Mufa'il is what? While the ismul fa'il is what? Mu'allim, a person that teaches, a teacher. While the ismul maf'ul is what? Mu'allam, something that is being taught. That is what? That is mu'allam. Fa'ilul amri, allim, teach. It is a command so that is an amru. That what? Allim, you're asking somebody to what? To teach, an imperative. La to allim is a fa'ilul nahi, which is what? A prohibition. Do not teach. So that's a negative or imperative verb. La to allim fa'ilul nahi. So we have allama, yu'allimu, ta'liman, mu'allimun, mu'allamun, allim. La tu'allim. So finally we have the last verb under the fa'il ruba'i, which is the last shape is what? Fa'lala. So fa'lala, when it becomes mudar, it becomes yufa'lilu. And in masdar, it can have two shapes, which is what? Fa'lalatan or aw fi'lalan. Then ismul fa'il is mufa'lilu. The ismul maf'ul is mufa'lalun. Then the fa'ilul amri is fa'lil. And the fa'ilul nahi is la tufa'lil. So an example there is what? Jalbaba. Jalbaba means what? He wore a jilbab. So that is in the past tense, the final madi. Jalbaba, he wore a jilbab. Then yujalbibu, he is wearing a jilbab or he wears a jilbab. Yujalbibu. Then we have the masdar is what? Jalbabatan au jilbaban. So that's where the word jilbab comes from the verb jalbaba. So the masdar, the verbal noun is what? Jilbaban or jalbabatan. That is what? The act of wearing jalbab or to wear jalbab. Then mujallibibun, the ismul fa'il mujallibibun, a person that wears jilbab. مجلبابون, which is اسم المفعول. Then we have the فعل الأمر جلبيب. This is an imperative meaning. Wear the jilbab or put on the jilbab. La tujalbib. Do not put on the jilbab. So that is the sorfu table for ruba'iyun. So we'll do a brief recap for each of the verb classes. The first shape waznu of ruba'i is what? Af'ala. So we have af'ala, yuf'ilu, if'alan, muf'ilun, muf'alun, af'il, la taf'il. Then the second verb we have is what? Fa'alala. Alun fa'il la tu fa'il. And the final verb is what? Fa'ilala. The final wasn is fa'ilala. Fa'ilala yu fa'ilu fa'ilalatan au fi'ilalan mufa'ilun mufa'ilalun fa'ilil la tu fa'ilil. So those are the awzan of the ruba'i, the four lettered verbs. And that is how they come on the sorfu table. So alhamdulillah, we've come to the end of today's sorfu class. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum.